Pivoting is a technique that provides an easy way to transform row values into columns. Here is a table named Sales 3, and it has five columns: year, quarter, area, units, and sales amount. This table has 48 rows with sales data for 3 years, 2018 through 2020. Let's say we want to pivot on the quarter column so that we can produce a result that shows sales for each quarter by year. In our select statement, notice that we are specifying just one column to aggregate, sales, for our pivot operation. And we are also specifying quarter as the column we are going to pivot on, and in the in list, we have identified the specific quarter values, Q1 through Q4, that we want to transform into columns. Now let's run this SQL statement. Notice that the results of this pivot query returned 48 rows, which is the same number of rows in the table, and it returned a lot of nulls. So, why did we get this unexpected result? Since all the columns in our table were passed into the pivot function, we got quarterly sales not just by year, but by year, area, and units. We have 48 distinct units values, which, by the way, is a measure column. So we ended up with 48 rows in the pivot table. We can resolve getting these types of unexpected results by pre-selecting the columns of interest. It's highly recommended to always include a derived table with the list of columns of interest. Let's look at the syntax to pre-select the columns so we can avoid these types of unexpected results. Basically, the only difference between this query and the previous one is that in the from clause, we replace sales 3 with a derived table. So now the from clause is followed by a derived table where we pre-select the columns that we want passed to the pivot function. In this derived table, we are selecting 3 of the 5 columns from our sales 3 table: year, quarter, and sales. The columns area and units will not be used for this pivot operation. Let's run the SQL statement. Instead of returning 48 rows, now we have 3 rows of quarterly results by year. In this video, I showed how pivoting is an easy way to transform row values into columns.